Listen to those birds. That's not a bird. That's a tuba, my favorite musical instrument. Listen, it's playing my favorite song. Opa in the Park with Ned. Oh boy, where is it coming from, huh? Where is it?
Excuse me, I've got to be going.
Wait. How do you do it? How do you make that sound?
Oh, simple, really. I just open my mouth and...
That's amazing!
I really must be going.
No, please, wait. Do you think you could maybe, you know, teach me to make that sound so I could show Ernie? Please.
All you've got to do is take a deep breath, open your mouth, and think.
Okay. I'll take a deep breath, open my mouth, and think tuba. Okay, here goes. Okay, watch me, okay?
Well, I haven't got all day.
Please, wait, I wasn't concentrating. Let me try it again, okay? Tuba. Okay, I'm in the mood now. Here we go. This will be good.
I certainly hope so.
Take a deep breath, open my mouth, think tuba.
Really, some people have it, some people don't.
Oh,
I'm
please,
afraid
please.
You don't.
Wait, please, I'm getting close. Give me one more chance, okay?
Look.
What's that?
Perhaps this picture will help. It's a picture of a...
That's it. That's great. You helped me. That'll do it. Okay. Now, take a deep breath, open my mouth, and think of that picture, that thing there, tuba. Okay, here we go.
Please, I'm in a hurry.
Okay, here we go. Where is he? Where is that bull who's called me?
He's over there.
Oh, wait, that was the sound of a tuba. It's supposed to be, not a ball.
Oh, you are beautiful. Please do it again.
I'm
in love.
Wait.
Please, Ernie.
Oh, yeah, this looks like a perfect place. Yeah. Oh, this is so exciting. I am going to try my pigeon calls, and this looks like a great place for it. Now, I have been practicing all week, and all I'm going to do is yell, coo, coo, and pigeons from all over are going to come right here to my feet. This is going to be terrific. Here we go. Coo, coo, coo.
Moo, moo, moo.
You're not a pigeon, you're a cow.
I know that. I thought I heard someone calling me. Moo! Oh, moo!
No. I was calling pigeons with coo, coo.
Oh, well, coo and moo rhyme, don't they? They sound the same. An obvious mistake. Oh, sorry to have bothered you.
That's fine, lady. That's whatever. Okay, I'll try it again. Here we go. Coo!
Boo! Boo!
Boo?
No! Boo! Did you call me?
No, I'm not calling owls, I'm calling pigeons. Coo! Not who?
Coo and boo sound the same, you know.
Yeah, I know they rhyme, but I said coo!
Sorry, I'm going back to bed.
Oh, brother, I don't believe this. Okay, I'll try it one more time. Here we go. Coo! Coo!
Somebody call me?
You're the number two.
Yeah, I know that, my friend. What do you want?
I want pigeons. I said coo, not two, coo.
Hey, two and coo rhyme. They sound the same.
Yeah, fine, I know, but they're not the same, and I said coo.
Hey, don't yell at me. I can't help it if they sound the same. Sheesh.
All right, I'll try it one last time. Coo, coo. I didn't call you. I called Koo. You're a tiger. Tiger doesn't rhyme with Koo. No, that doesn't rhyme. That's not it either.
Yeah, but Sue sounds like Koo, and that's what I thought you said. So I brought the whole gang. Yeah. Since we're all here, we might as well party.
Monster, Elmo, no. But sometimes you're a loud monster.
A loud monster?
Yeah.
What do you mean, Bert?
That's what scared the pigeons away, your loudness. Pigeons like peace and quiet, like this.
Oh, pigeons like it quiet, like this. Not this!
Elmo, yes, quiet.
Elmo will be quiet like this, not like this!
Elmo!
Sorry, Bert. If Bert and Elmo sit here quietly, the pigeons will come back, and then Bert can feed them.
Never mind. They probably found someplace else to eat.
Bert thinks the pigeons found someplace to eat?
Yeah.
Far, far away?
Yeah.
Oh, Elmo knows how to fix that.
Was about to drop it on the sidewalk. when a pigeon looked up and it said, please keep the park clean for the pigeon. That is the right thing to do. Throw all your trash in the basket, and we will say thank you to you. Keep the park clean for the pigeon. When you eat candy or gum, throw what is left in the trash can. Think of your small feathered chum. Ever see a pigeon drop a soda can on the ground?
No!
No, when pigeons see breadcrumbs on the sidewalk, do they just leave them there?
No!
No, 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 they pick them up with their beaks. And not just because they're hungry, right?
No!
Right, because pigeons hate a mess. When there is trash on the sidewalk, they can't see breadcrumbs to eat. Cracker Jacks get in their feathers, aww, chewing gum sticks to their feet. So put your trash in your pocket. If there's no basket around, please keep it to throw away later. Remember that bird on the ground. And people!
Keep the park clean for the pigeon!
Pigeon!
And I love how they walk. And I've created a really cool dance called Doing the Pigeon. Doing the Pigeon. A dancing a little smidgen of the kind of ballet sweeps me away. Doing the Pigeon. Doing the Pigeon. People may smile, but I don't mind. They'll never understand the kind of fun I find. Doing the pigeon. I love it. Doing the pigeon. It's me. Doing the pigeon every day. Oh, boy, is that exciting? Now, I'll show you how to really do the dance good, okay? Oh, this is gonna be way out. Okay, feet, do your stuff. Dig this. Oh, I'm grooving now. Too much. People may smile, but I don't mind. They'll never understand the kind of fun I find. Doing the pigeon, doing the pigeon, doing the pigeon every day.
Hi, my favorite food of all is oatmeal. Yeah, it comes in a box like this, see? And you know what? I love this empty oatmeal box almost as much as I love oatmeal itself. Here's why. I love an oatmeal box. Give me an oatmeal box. Because an oatmeal box makes pretty music. Chick-a-boom. Just take an oatmeal box. You'll love an oatmeal box. Because an oatmeal box makes pretty music. Chick-a-boom, chick-a-boom. And if you don't have an oatmeal box, then any old box will do. Just chick-a and chick-a. And you make music too. Oh, I love an oatmeal box. A lovely oatmeal box. cause an oatmeal box makes pretty music. Just a full instrumental. Nice, huh? We'll have it. Now, what's this? Chicka-chicka-chicka-boom. And if you don't have an oatmeal box, then any old box will do. Just chicka. And chicka. And you make music, too. Oh, I love an oatmeal box. Oh, a lovely oatmeal box. Because an oatmeal box makes pretty music. Because... makes pretty music. Stand back. Chick-a-boom, boom, boom.
Yes?
You know, I think I can... I've heard some people count back from 10 backwards. Can you do that?
Yes.
Okay, can you do that for me?
All right.
Okay, go ahead.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Wow, that's great.
Hey, John John?
Wow.
And Sherlock, you want to count?
Oh, yes.
John John, you want to count?
Yeah.
Okay, I tell you what, I'll start first and you second.
Sherlock.
What?
Sherlock.
Yes, John John.
What count?
Oh, I'd love to count.
Okay, good.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
That was terrific!
Yeah, that's fantastic, John John.
Yeah. Oh, my mommy said so. Like
Oh, whoops. Well, I don't know what to do about that.
Hey, Fred. Hey,
well, maybe if we're really
Uncle
good,
Bert's gonna be here.
Maybe they'll tell us.
Boys and girls?
Well, I don't know.
Boys and girls? Hello, boys and girls. Boys and girls?
Really good.
Quiet! Thank you. I am here today to give you all a show and tell. And today, my show and tell is about my rock. Most people want a doggy or a yellow parakeet. But if you ask me, I would say there's nothing quite as neat as a rock. My rock. It doesn't wag its tail, and it doesn't sing all day. But you never have to walk it, and it doesn't run away. My rock. My rock. It's quiet, and it's friendly, and it's always very neat. And you never have to bathe it. And it never has to eat. Oh, you can have your hamsters and your goldfish by the score. If I live to be 100, I will never ask for more than my rock. My rock. Upon what does a bullfrog like to hop? A rock. What once was our majestic mountain top? A rock. What once was at the bottom of the sea? A rock. What hurts if I should drop it on your knee? A rock. What forms the firm foundation of a wall? A rock. What makes the very bestest pet of all? That's right, a rock. All poodle pups and parakeets are all you ever see. And rocks are only really loved by guys like me. But let me tell ya, mister, if you had one, you'd agree. There's nothing quite so wonderful or truly remarkable as a rock.
Okay, watch this, Betty Lou.
Okay, Bert.
How about that?
Oh, you're very good, Bert.
I've been practicing.
You have?
Yeah.
Oh, that's wonderful. You're so relaxed, Bert.
Well, as relaxed as I can get.
That's really scary.
Yeah.
Oh, it's fun.
This is the hip part.
Oh, okay.
I got to touch my foot in a minute.
Oh.
Say, yeah.
Perfect.
I think I'll do it again.
Oh, Mom, it hit me that time.
Oh, watch me. I'll do it again.
Oh, I'm using my... Oh, I'll race you.
Do it again.
brush your hair? Good question, Dorothy.
This is how I brush my hair, Dorothy. Dorothy, I don't use a brush, I use a comb. Dorothy, I use a pick.
Thank you, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Oh, hi, baby. Oh, baby, how do you... Baby, how do you brush your hair? Wait a minute. You don't have a lot of hair to brush. That's cool. Thank you, baby. Oh, Elmo has lots of hair all over Elmo's body. It's called fur, and it needs lots of brushing. Hey, Elmo has a question for you. How many hairbrushes does it take to brush Elmo's fur? Let's count them and see.
One
hairbrush. Two hairbrushes. Three hairbrushes. Four hairbrushes. Cool haircut, Joseph. Elmo likes it too.
brushing his hair. Looking good, Mr. Noodle. Keep brushing. But Elmo still wants to find out more about hair. But how can Elmo find out more? Oh, yeah, good idea, TV. We can watch the Hair Channel. Turn on.
Thank you. You're watching the Hair Channel. All hair, all the time. And now, here's our story.
The kingdom where everybody's hair looked the same. Once upon a time, there was a kingdom where everybody's hair looked the same.
I, your king, hereby decree that everyone should wear their hair just like mine.
And everyone did. The royal chef wore her hair just like the king's. The royal jester wore his hair just like the king. Even the royal hamster wore his hair just like the king. Everyone in the entire kingdom wore their hair just like the king's. Everyone, that is, except for little Liddy LaRue.
Little girl, why doesn't your hair look the same as mine?
I'm sorry, Your Majesty, but no matter what I do, my hair won't go that way. It's just different. Besides, I like it this way. I really like it.
But this is the kingdom where everybody's hair looks the same. You can't have hair that looks different.
But, Your Majesty, what's wrong with everybody having different hairstyles?
What's wrong with it? I'll tell you what's wrong with it. Nothing.
So the king made a new decree.
I, your king, hereby decree that from now on, everybody can wear their hair any way they want.
And everybody did. They wore their hair in all different kinds of styles and colors, and they all looked good. Even the king got a new style. And that looked good, too.
Hey, bald is beautiful.
And soon there were so many different beautiful hairstyles that they had to rename the kingdom where everyone has different hairstyles. The end!
Coming up next, From Hair to Eternity, followed by When Harry Met Sally.
Thank you, TV.
Very nice hair. Elmo loves all different kinds of hair. Straight, curly, short, long. What's the longest hair in the world? Excuse Elmo.
You want to see the world's longest hair?
Yeah.
You got it!
Sorry. Wow. This hair is really long. Who are you?
Oh, well, I'm Rapunzel. You know, from the story of Rapunzel?
Huh?
I'm the one who was locked in the tall tower and people had to climb up my hair to get in. You know, like that.
Oh, yeah. Elmo loves that story. And so does Dorothy. Oh, look, look. Dorothy's imagining Elmo in the story of Rapunzel.
Oh, boy, oh, boy.
It's really lonely in this tower. Somebody get Rapunzel out of here. Help! Somebody help!
Do not worry, fair Rapunzel. I, the very handsome prince, will save you. Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair.
Okay.
Here I come to save the fair Rapunzel.
Okay.
Oh, it's all right. Here I come.
Back.
Hey.
Oh, thank goodness you're here. Now, Rapunzel, you get out of this tower.
Yeah, but how?
Like this. Come on.
What's the crowd?
Okay. Gotcha. Yeah. Looking good.
You like this?
Looking good.
Oh, it's my style.
See ya.
Oh, bye. It's conditioned at all.
Oh, Rapunzel's free. Yay.
Yeah. Woohoo.
Oh, thank you, Prince. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Yes.
Goodbye. Wait a minute. No, I'm stuck in this tower. Rapunzel, come back.
hairbrush and mousse.
Oh, well, that's not exactly how the story goes, but I liked it.
That
fish of yours has some imagination.
She sure does.
Yes, well, anyway, I've got to go. I have an appointment at the beauty parlor. I'm thinking of wearing my hair up, way up. See you, Elmo.
Bye, Rapunzel. Bye.
Oh, dear. Oh, sorry.
Oh, boy. The third time this week.
Thank you. All right, Elmo?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I'm so sorry about my hair. Tell you what, I'll leave that way.
Okay.
Okay, bye, Elmo. Okay. Bye.
Bye. Bye, Rapunzel.
Wow.
Boy, Rapunzel sure has really long hair. Elmo has a friend who has really short hair. Bert. Elmo loves Bert's hair. That's why Elmo made a video about Bert's hair with Claire's camera. It's called Bert's Hair by Elmo. TV! TV, where are you? There you are, TV. Are you so fine?
Elmo, what's going on? I was taking a bath, and now what? What do you want me to do?
Oh, just hold still, Bert.
What?
Just hold still.
Okay.
Okay? All right. Here we go. There. See, this is Bert's hair. See how it sticks up all by itself?
Well, I just took a bath. Of course, I washed it.
Oh, well, Elmo loves Bert's hair. Can Elmo touch Bert's hair?
Oh, no, I still have to put that gunk on it first.
Oh, please, Bert, please.
All right, Elmo.
Okay. The woo-woo-woo. Oh, la la.
Did you enjoy yourself?
Oh, thanks, Bert.
Are you finished now?
No. And that's Bert's hair by Elmo. Now Elmo's finished, but now we get to play. Come on, Bert.
No, I gotta put some gunk in my hair and comb it now.
Oh, come on, Bert. Oh, thank you, TV. Elmo loves hair. So does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the hair song. You okay, TV? What's wrong? You want to dance and sing too? Okay. Here we go. Sing along too. Hair, 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 hair. Nice dancing, TV. Come on, everybody. Hair, 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 hair. Oh, look. Mr. Noodle's finally finishing brushing his hair.
Something that they love, and so we may as well let you know
the things we are fondest of. Oh, we love
pigeons
and cookies
and trash.
Such fun to
hang on or talk to
or mash. So delicious and chewy.
So delightful and cooey, rot, yucky, and fooey. I guess that I'm just different than you. We eat
gems and cookies
and trash. Just
hear them coo-coo and crunch, crunch
and crash.
Yeah.
Everybody loves something, as sure as that mustache. We love
gems and cookies
and trash.
Oh, Bernice, no guy anywhere loves a pigeon more than I love you.
Look at this stuff. All ratty and dingy, all worn out and broken. Grouches everywhere love trash, and I'm proud to be among them.
Okay, so delicious and chewy.
So delightful and chewy. Rot, yucky, and fooey.
these great products from Sesame Street. Who doesn't have a favorite song?
Everybody does.
If you love kids' favorite songs, then you'll want to join Elmo and his Sesame Street friends for Kids' Favorite Songs, too. Pick your favorite from 15 songs, all guaranteed to get you dancing.
The wheels on the bus go round and round.
Rubber ducky, you're the one.
Plus, there's an extra special bonus, the Sesame Street feature Hero Guy.
I didn't expect to see that.
Kids' Favorite Songs, too. Coming this October on video, CD, and cassette. Only from Sesame Street and Sony Wonder.
I love it! Elmo's a cowboy in the Wild Wild West! Yay!
Elmo's World Wild Wild West, an all-new home video special. Hop on your pony and join Elmo and his partners on a Wild West adventure.
He put the wild in the Wild Wild West. Was the riding, roping this cowboy.
She'll be coming round the mountain when she comes. She'll be coming round the mountain. She'll be coming round the mountain.
A video your kids will enjoy till the cows come home.
It's musical. It's magical. It's Elmo.
This is going to be fun.
Elmo's Musical Adventure. The story of Peter and the Wolf on VHS and DVD.
That's what Elmo's thinking about today.
Give up? Now you can find out whenever you want when you visit Elmo's World with a special collection of 50-minute videos on VHS, only from Sesame Street and Sony Wonder.
Elmo is so happy to see you.
Join your favorite furry red 3-year-old, his goldfish Dorothy, and friend Mr. Noodle in Elmo's World as they check out dancing, music, and books.
Elmo will show you.
You'll be surprised how much there is to know about the fun-filled worlds of babies, dogs, and life on the farm. Elmo and his pals will show you all about singing, drawing, and telephones whenever you come to visit.
Hello?
Think you know everything about flowers, bananas, and hair? You'll think again when you hear what Elmo has to say. Need a reason to party? Then get ready for an extra special celebration with your favorite furry red friend when Elmo investigates birthdays, games, and pets.
Elmo's got game, that's right.
Make Elmo's World a part of your world with these special videos now on VHS, only from Sesame Street and Sony Wonder.
Elmo's World! It would be great to be a firefighter.
Join Elmo in the new video, Elmo Visits the Firehouse. Meet real firefighters and learn about what to do if there's a fire.
What's a firehouse?
Get Elmo Visits the Firehouse today.
Elmo had to get now and down.
There. Get out, stay out, don't you go back in.
Don't you go back in. You're safe now, kitty.
Available only on Sesame Street video and DVD.
Firefighters.
Only from Sony Wonder.